Today's coffee break is on setting up and issuing reminders. So it's not unusual for us to want to go ahead and send reminders out to our customers, letting them know what's past due. And sometimes there's a finance charge associated with that process. So the first thing we want to do is we want to go ahead and set up the reminders. So you do that in the financial management menu under receivables. And it's all the way down here under administration and reminder terms. So the first thing we want to do is create our terms. So I have two different categories of terms. I have domestic customers and foreign customers. And really the only difference is that I give the foreign customers a little bit more of a grace period, but basically they're the same. So you can have one reminder term code set up for all your customers, or you may want to break it out if you have different sort of aging criteria for the reminders. So let me just show you how I've set this one up. I've set up my domestic reminder term, and what I want to do is create levels of reminders. So I go to levels, and I have here three different levels. So I have a grace period of 5 days, and I have a 1 month, and then the second month. And each of those has an additional fee. So the fees will increment with each of the reminders that go out. If you do the fee, you don't have to use a fee, but if you do include a fee, you're going to need to set up a GL account to capture that fee. And that is done in the customer posting setup. I'll just pop over here for a second and show you. Sorry, the customer posting groups. And that is right here. So that additional fee account needs to be created in the customer posting groups. All right, if you use it. So let's go ahead and go back to our reminder terms. And I just want to go to those levels again. And basically what you're doing is you're creating a level, you're putting in grace period, and then you're putting in that fee. With that, you can put text. So this text will be automated. And in this case, I've put ending text. So basically at the bottom of my reminder, I will see text that shows this particular reminder. So here we have, please remit your payment of %7 as soon as possible. %7 is actually going to be replaced with the total of the reminder. That is a special code that will prompt the system to do a calculation. And just to show you, here are the text variables for the reminder. So now you can get a screenshot of that. And the one I'm using is %7, which will take the total, which is the remaining amount of the invoice, plus any interest, any additional fees, and tax, and it will sum it all up. And we're going to go ahead and see this in action. All right. And for each of these, you can have different ending text. So the text may get more aggressive. In this case, this has been sent to our attorney. So you can sort of escalate the different reminders. Once that's set up, you'll just go to the customer card, and you will flag them as a customer that needs to have a reminder sent to them. So you will do that on the payment tab of the customer card. There's a reminder terms code here, and I'm going to put in that code that I've just created. So now when I generate reminders, this customer will be included. All right. So to generate reminders, we just go to financial management, periodic activities, receivables, and reminders. You just click on this create reminders button, and you can put different filtering criteria, different dates, things like that. You click OK, and it will generate the reminders. Now, these aren't issued yet. These are just suggestions. So you have an opportunity to delete them. If you know that they've already sent in a payment, it hasn't been processed yet, you could delete it. And you can edit them. So let's just double click on one to see what it looks like. So here we have a list of all the credit memos and invoices for this customer. We have that additional fee of $770, and we have our text. And that %7 has been replaced with the total for this reminder. So once I approve a reminder, I can go ahead and issue it. So I go to Actions and Issue. So issuing it will print it out, and it will also create an entry including that additional fee for the customer's account. So I go to Issue, and I click OK, and it's going to go away because it's been issued. So you'll just go through your list, one at a time, and you'll make any edits. You can edit the amounts. You can delete a given row if you want. Whatever it is, you know, it's within your control. And as you do each one, you'll just issue them. Okay. And once that's done, you'll be able to go to the customer card and see those issued reminders. All right, so from the customer's account, you can go to Navigate, Documents, Issued Reminders. And I don't have any for this one. Yay. Let's look at this guy instead. Issued Reminders. There we go. And from here, you could always reprint the reminder and send it to them. You can preview it. You can email it. So this is the reminder that went out. And this is the detail that they see. So they'll see all of the dates, all the documents and the document numbers, and the remaining amount due, and of course your totals. That concludes our lesson on creating reminders.
Thanks for watching this ArcherPoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.